Right, Leo, I'm going to read this one to you. This is the Father Gate. I was meditating on your reading. By meditating, I mean I was sitting here thinking, Leo, 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 the last few readings I've done for you, there's been such a push towards those of you that want to take your career or your life purpose, or I feel like your career and your life purpose is all mixed up in one thing, in a more entrepreneurial direction, in a more spiritual direction, and in a combination of entrepreneur, I can't even say it, and spirituality. Okay? The Father Gate is a card that you get when you're kind of treading water where you are. And you know that there's something, you get the call, okay? And you, or at least me on your behalf, I've been getting the call for you for 2 years. And I've been saying it and saying it and saying it and saying it. And I don't know, I think you're hearing it. So listen. When the Father Gate shows up, it is a clear call to lift your eyes to the horizon and walk towards your future. Okay? You're marching in place right now, stirring the dust, not getting there. Trust your forward movement, and I don't think it's just forward, but we'll get back to that, will lead you to a new destination, okay, that you already set for yourself, tick, but perhaps have forgotten or neglected because of everyday busyness, which is all of us, okay? The Father Gate comes to tell you an ending is at hand. You can leave the old behind, peel it away like an old skin. And we've talked about that, and we've talked about snakes and phoenixes as well. Okay? Don't hesitate, cross the threshold boldly. Cross the threshold. I'm getting a bit Sean Connery. And you will be rewarded, Leo. If you continue marking time, you're going to miss the opportunity. I'm waggling my finger, the gate is open. The next landscape of your life is within reach. But the window of time to pass through it grows shorter. Do not dally. Who says that? Do not dally. Do not shilly-shally. A gift of the Father Gate is to bring you the fullest expression of your gifts, perhaps for the first time. I don't think it's the first time. It's the first time you're putting it out there, but I don't think it's the first time it's come to mind. It's an invitation to a sacred passage, a new discovery, both great challenges and opportunities. It's not a graduation. There are no rewards other than the exploration itself. You've been a farmer far too long, tilling the hard soil that now bears little fruit for you. Time to put your explorer hat on once again. Let's get into it, Leo. Let's get into it. Okay, I'm going to use Mystic Maidens for you because it's a strong deck and I'm feeling strong stuff. We're going to look at your love life. We're going to look at your life purpose, the whole bit, okay? No stone unturned. Don't need those now. Done my bossy reading bit. Don't normally do a bossy reading bit, but I just really felt like I was sitting here, Leo, and I was thinking, I keep saying this to Leo. I keep doing like these readings and I keep saying, I can feel it, I can feel it, I can feel it, and I really can feel it for you. It feels like an uprising and an awakening. It may not be very comfortable. Some of you, and I'm getting a channeled message. This is a weird channeled message. Some of you may have like lower back. I mean, Leo does rule the back. Lower back issues, like I think they call it lumbago, or issues like sitting, like coccyx and thighs and, you know, that kind of some sort of sacral chakra and that chakra, I can't remember the name of the base chakra. It will come to me. Okay, so we're talking red and we're talking orange and we're talking fire and we're talking blood energy. Okay, it's going to be a weird one. Let's get into it. Okay, nice, actually. You get the Four of Wands. The Four of Wands is a card, it's 11-11, it's Twin Flame, it's got that kind of juju about it where it's a portal into the unknown, okay? Nice. A bit like crashing when you were younger, or maybe now because you are Leo, crashing a really good party that you never knew was going to be good. You know, you were like, yeah, let's just try this. Let's give it a go, you know. Next thing you know, you frank the tank and everything is moving. Okay, Google it if you don't know. Four of Wands is luck. It's also good juju. It's almost like a kind of portal or a wormhole into goodness and weirdness and the esoteric. I've had a little theory about you that you, a lot of Leos I know are good tarot readers, but they take it a bit further. Like, I know Leos that are witches and shamans and energy healers, all sorts, Reiki the lot. There's a certain kind of authority with being a Leo that works really well in the more esoteric and dramatic professions, if you want to call it a profession. It's the kind of thing that swings between something that you just do and something that you might just start doing all the time. Okay, with the Four of Wands you get the Moon. Now this is a borrowed light card. It's feminine energy, lunar energy, your fixed fire energy, you're quite yang energy, and yet you have this side to you, okay, this lunar energy, mysterious side. There is a lot of mystique about you at the moment, okay? Mystery and mystique. So you are discovering things, but people find you mysterious while you're looking for mysterious things yourself. I know, and it's typically what you're going to get when what you're seeking is what is seeking you. So you're seeking to bring enlightenment to people. People will start seeking you out for enlightenment, okay? You may also be seeking enlightenment with like one person that is your regular guru person, whether that's online, whether that's IRL, okay? Page of Pentacles. This is very sweet energy. It's the energy of maybe starting in an apprenticeship, and that can be literal or spiritual, that you're learning something new, or that you're taking a leap from what you do every day with your altar or what you're doing with your tarot cards, and maybe thinking, I'm going to start a YouTube channel, or thinking, I want to set up a stall at the spiritual fair, or I am going to start healing people. I've been doing it for ages with my friends, okay? This is the energy of the Pentacle, so it could be monetized. And you may need to discover the bridge between spirituality and entrepreneurship, okay? And this is the beginning of it. And there may be somebody who can advise you with that, okay? Then, frustratingly, I suppose, you get this beautiful, gorgeous Hanged Man card. You're in a strange lull. You know when we had the Father Gate and it said you're kind of at the entrance here, and you can see this in the distance, but, and I hate to say this because Leos are very confident. It could simply be a lack of confidence. It could be that you're in quite a safe position with what you're doing and you want that safe position to continue, but you're also longing for something else. It's a bit of push and pull here. Don't fear the push and pull. Push and pull is what creates friction and what gets you to move and change, okay? I feel like this is sort of entering 2025 territory. We're practically there now anyway, okay? Yes, look, you even get a magic wand. I've always wanted a magic wand. When the boy was little, we had one of those Harry Potter ones that was really good, you know, Expelliarmus and all that stuff. I think I liked it more than he did. Anyway, look, this is putting fire to the magic, lighting the touch paper, and retiring to watch. And I talked to you a few times last reading about my friend and burning down the house. She didn't burn down her house, she just set fire to her bin. But, and I'm not advocating that, I'm just saying she's a crazy Leo. She's like one of my best friends. And every now and again, that fire just needs to rage for her in whatever way it's going to happen. So there's something about you and your fire and your spirit and you're kind of finding ways to direct it rather than have it direct you. But also you have something to teach other people about finding their fire. You could be a life coach with this. You could be a recruitment consultant. You are being called a care assistant. You're being called to inspire and help other people to find their fire. Okay. I'm very excited. I'm so excited now. This is one of my favorite cards of all the tarot decks I own. And by God, do I own a lot. So this, if anybody likes it, because I always get asked, is the Mystic Maidens Tarot by Hattie Thorne. The Sun card is delectable. It's so Leo, and it is Leo because the Sun is what rules you. Remember that it is the Sun that rules you. It's just this last kind of dip in confidence that we need to get you over. Okay? I'm loving this for you. See how this segues into your love reading, okay? Let's take some love cards for Leo. Just going to move those here. So if these love cards resonate, there will, as there is every month, be an extended love reading. And that is the first link in the description box. It's these three that I can't take my eyes off. I love these three. Even though that's the Hanged Man, Hanged Woman. There's something about being upside down, like in inverted yoga poses, right? About gaining all this wisdom, crown chakra, any kind of chakra work. You may help others with chakra work, but we've now identified three for you. We've got like third eye as well, crown, third eye, and we're practically there. Sacral chakra and the base chakra, which I still haven't remembered the name of. Okay, love life. What's going on for you in your love life? Three of swords. Holy moly. Okay. And the death card. Something has to change. If you get the three of swords, you are operating with old wounds. Okay. Old wounds are showing up in your love life. There's the rest of your cards. They just went on the floor. And that, they're looking pretty nice. Okay. Yeah, look. That one isn't. There's some nice ones though, because I just saw them. Three of Swords, what is holding you back? Is it an ex? Is it trust issues? Is it something? And by the way, a lot of Leos look really good with red hair, just saying. Let me know in the comments if you've gone for that in some way. My friend does. She looks amazing when she does her hair with red. Because she's a Leo as well. She does all sorts of weird things with her hair because she's daring. Three of Swords. This is holding you back. I'm going to take another card on that in a minute. Death card. It's time. It's time. Okay. It's time with the Father Gate. If you think about that gate in the distance. And it's time with the Death card. You cannot play safe any longer. Does not suit a Leo to play safe in their love life anyway. You're a lion for freak's sake. You're supposed to be showing the rest of us how to do it. You've got the Sun. You've got the Ace of Wands. You've got the Ten of Wands, though, too. This, whatever this is, holding you back. Do you remember it said, shed it like an old skin? Find your spirit animal. I think yours is a snake, but obviously it varies from individual. I've been getting snakes and tigers and lions for you for ages because I keep getting how difficult it is for a snake to like undulate and shed its own skin. Never thought I'd be miming a snake undulating. It looks a lot better than that. Okay, Ace of Swords. Oomph. This is information, perhaps information that you need coming in, but it's also a bit of an aha moment, which we like, but it's also very, very direct boundaries. I want to say sharp boundaries. It's you when you're absolutely in your full confidence about your boundaries, okay? You're going to need to be, because you can't carry this load for whoever it is any longer. And this load could be ancestral, it could be from parents, it could be from your ex, it could be from someone you're with now, whatever it is. You need to shirk this, you need to drop this, okay? Page of Wands, just in time. Page of Wands, the most junior of the fire cards, of the Wands cards. It's like you had the Page of Pentacles for the entrepreneurial side of things, okay, which is like the beginning of holding the pentacle. We then have the Page of Wands, which is the beginning of the fire, lighting the spark, okay? Something needs to shift in your relationship world, and it may be you that brings the spark that causes that change, okay? Oof, there it is. Look at that Eight of Cups. Look at you go. Okay. Ooh, that's kiss my... That is. That is. If somebody is overstepping the mark, or if they are not stepping up enough, they snooze, they lose. Okay? They snooze, they lose. No negotiation is... You should not enter a negotiation unless you're willing to walk away. Okay? Interesting. That's a power move. Someone else got that. Who was it? It was Scorpio, I think. Seven of Cups, gaslighting. No more of that. Okay, it can be gaslighting, but it can also just be vagueness. You will know which one it is according to how you feel. Oof. Now, this kiss my ass is such a power move. Don't mess with it unless you're ready and you're willing, okay? It's not an ultimatum. It's not done to make them do something or scare them, you know, any of that. It's too painful to stay the same, so I'm not going to. And let me tell you, the reward for this is big. Big, big, big. Because you then get another page. This is like the dawning of something. It's the beginning of something. You get the Page of Cups. Now, the Page of Cups is very often an apology. Interesting. So, and like I say, fortune favours the brave, but you're not being brave because you want the apology. That's weak, actually. Makes you dependent. It makes you sort of, I don't know, it's just not authentic. If this is authentic and genuine, and if this is your power move, you're going to get an apology or you're going to get a love offer. Whether it's with the same person, who cares, actually? I know you do care, but be open to anything. You don't do that because you want the attention of one person. It's not a power move. That's manipulation, actually. And you're sort of manipulating yourself. If you mean this, if you mean this, if you're very clear, Ace of Swords, if you want to make peace with this and process this and a complete change, and you want to drop that Ten of Wands, be that Eight of Cups and work it. Absolutely drop the mic. Done. Because you then get the Two of Cups. Thank me later. I love this. And you deserve no less, but you must light the flame under whatever arse you need to light the flame under, even if it's your own. Okay, I'm going to go do your extended love reading, which I'm very excited about. I'm going to look at the Page of Cups, the Two of Cups. I'm going to look at the Death card and the Three of Swords. I'm going to do some shadow work. I'm going to look into that as well. I'm going to look into your person, what's going on with them, the dynamic, the best way forward. First link in the description box. Leave me a comment. Love to read your comments, okay? I need more comments from Leos. I want to know what's going on about your spiritual business as well. Namaste.